just to give you my history. I am a veteran police officer, I'm a veteran supervisor, so whenever we hear things such as this, it's extremely important that we get to the bottom of it, and that's why I'm here, and that's why I've been so aggressively speaking with people like your attorney and some other ones and other people.
I'm glad that you're acknowledging that you have been aggressive with your phone calls today. Thank you for that, Investigator Jones.
Well, that's important to me because if there's a police officer that's doing something wrong, or maybe we're not sure what it is, but it's important to me that I get to the bottom of it, and I will go to any length.
Sure, the purpose of this call from Brent and I's perspective is to reorient that aggression, and let's put a spotlight not on the accuser, but on the content. If you don't mind, I'll take over here, Investigator Jones, and I do speak for Mr. Browning. If at any point I do not, Mr. Browning's not shy about interrupting me. The number one thing is that Mr. Browning and I both feel very uncomfortable, Investigator Jones, with repeated phone calls to both our work and personal numbers during the business day. Number two is that although we are not the victims of this sexual trauma, it is very concerning for us that